Charter, make me tell you them bend down flatter. And school book man, them backer. Miss Akia
DJ. Push summertime. Going to do another summer now, right? Still in summertime. Let me give you a little bit of my local celebrity Logic. Let's go.
It's that young Sinatra 4 shit right here.
Rest in peace, Mac Miller.
It's been like 10 years. Here we go. Yeah. Visualizing and realizing my life is fucking crazy. Popping like Jay-Z. Dirty dancing on the game like Swayze. I'm one of the innocent, bitch. I've been ready to kill us. It's so amazing. Bitch, I've been blazing. I'm talking grass. I ain't talking grazing. They just sit the tape while I sip scotch. Let the haters kick rocks. My city's tip-top, but never flip-flop. Why? Cause my soul too strong. Did this all on my own. Cause waiting took too long. The flow sophisticated. All these youngins do is whine like they inebriated. I'm hated, but yeah, that's how you know I made it. I'm one of the illest. I'm one of the realest. I'm one of the killers. The people, they feel us. Me and my team made millions, but you know we still us. That's why they wanna kill us. That's why they wanna kill us. Rap pack, real all the time. We never phony. I'm single-handedly running the game like a Sony. But the rest of these rappers is acting. Pass them to Tony. Pass them to Oscar. From the new school rappers. Yeah, I'm the illest on the roster. Smoke like a rock. Black and white like Bob Marley. Yeah, like Bob Marley. These racist motherfuckers hate that last line. Probably haters on the internet ain't got nothing to bargain. Said I'd never make a bitch, I just sold out the garden.
Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high. Cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high. Cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high. Cause you never know when you're gonna go.
Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we sip scotch like Sinatra screaming motherfuck the cops.
They say they want the old Logic, the one that flow like a faucet. I'm still the same me, they just don't believe it like they agnostic. If I spit over the boom bath, then they perceive it as nostalgic. But the truth is, my subject matter has been the same. And my production selection is still flame. But they love you on the come up cause you ain't tainted by fame. And you still they little secret. That's the type of bullshit that they frequent. From 19 to 2019, been murdering this shit for a decade. From the boom bap to the trap, I let my shit cascade. Listen, yeah. Yeah, so what's the dilly? Pass the Philly, get silly, that's on the really. We snappin' like Uma Thurman and Kill Bill, I'm talking Achilles. Try to play me like I ain't me, but I provided all the deets. Who you know worth 50 million, still rapping on breakbeats. From Nasty Nas, Big L Tribe, The Roots, and many more. Of course, we can never forget Biggie and Young Shakur. Fuck the police, no, we ain't fucking with El Pastor. I'm the bastard that mastered the flow, said it once before for show. While Six produced the kicks from the soul, you already know. Fuck these youngins talking out of they ass with no class. I'm here to school them, just that real shit, I'm never fooling. I'm killing these squares, we call it the mass taker. I got the bread, but these fuckers need the dough like a baker. The legends above me love me like the RZA, like Nas, like Jay. Cause I mastered the flow from back in the day. Respected by my peers from Drizzy to Cole to Kenny. Thank you for the love and inspiration plenty. Yeah, I'm loved by many and only hated by a little. Now I think it's time to switch the lyricism, peep the riddle. I was born in mint condition, I'm everybody's life mission. Alright, listen, put me round your neck and I might glisten. The ultimate connect, I get you anything you need. From good credit to good weed, I can make any woman succeed. Control you with the heart of greed. Along with anybody that's in need, I make them beg and plead. I'm in the pocket of mafia, crime lords and presidents. Without me, they'll evict you from your residence. Hope wrote about me on dead presidents. Never irrelevant, not a soul on earth would love me if I weren't me. No matter what year I'm in, I'm currency. People that have me, yeah, they power so immense. But people without me make no sense, goddamn. Yeah, the world revolve around me, the law evolve around me. The shit people do to get a piece of me astound me. Blood stains my face when drug deals go wrong. I'm giving to the greatest athletes when they go long. You could put me in check, but I'm still laughing all the way to the bank. I'm the reason that the Titanic sank. I'm always there for you, yeah, when it comes down to the wire. And some people even tuck me away till they retire. I usually come around on the 1st and 15th. If you owe me to somebody, then they'll leave you beneath. People go crazy when they feel me. In the Middle East, they drill me. If you let your guard down, then some people will steal me. I knew these two dudes that's always been homies since 5th grade. Always scheming on the block, selling crack to get paid. Now they never graduated, thought that shit a charade. Only thing on their mind that wasn't me was get laid. And one day, They had a falling out on the block. See, one thought the other one had been stealing his rock, cause he could've sworn he had more weight in the stock. Pulled out the Glock and his homie out stopped. But before he had the chance to pull the trigger, oh shit, here come the cops. They saw the gun and blew them both away. Now there's two more kids dead in the street, all before 20. Over me, the most important thing to man, money.
Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go.
Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we sip scotch like Sinatra, screaming motherfuck the cops.
We just some motherfucking kids. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Logic, for setting the tone. Feel me Friday. And I got the first request. Big up to everybody in the VIP so early. It's Friday. And we got the tunes. I want you guys to bite this one, this President Tino, right here, exclusive. It's the first request of the day. It's DJ Push Play. Let's go.
Alright. Yo, this is J. Cole. What up? With DJ Payne 1.
Baby, you trippin', you bust. I was making something out of nothing. Chill for real, if we can't be lovers and friends, girl, you can show yourself to the door. Chill for real,
huh? Yeah. When I first met you, I was blushing on the set. Everything was in gear, thought we was on set. You played your part well, threw me off track. Now we sitting here playing Russian roulette. Pulling the trigger, seeing which one of us get hurt next. Now that's what I call a fucking domino effect. What happened to us? We supposed to manifest. I wish we could press reset. Instead, I'm sitting here soaking in my regrets, trying not to be depressed. You said you got something to confess. Better think twice before fucking with the next. I ain't got time for all that stress. You played your cards right, and I'ma press eject. No, I'm not beat. But it's to the left, and I'm pulling up to that bitch address. What's good?
I was making something out of nothing. Chill for real. Chill for real. If we can't be lovers and friends,
yo, J. Cole, what up? DJ Payne 1.
Chill for real. Chill for real.
Yo. Can't believe how long I took this nigga mess. Now I'm free, I'ma be a freak like my nigga Hugh Hef. Imagine another nigga hitting it from the back, or he got you running out of breath. And these bitches not having me, that's why their nigga keep trying to fuck with me, begging me to keep them company while we sip on some Hennessy. Whisper in my ear, that's why he feeling me.
Yeah, yeah, bro, keep texting me, trying to taste his 5-star meal, cause he knows good eat stuff. Him, cause I'm focused on chasing the meal. My ass so good, he trying to cop a bill.
Yo, J. Cole.
It's better than
BG.
None of you bitches can't be me. Grinding so hard, bitches don't see me. These musty bitches really think they could defeat me.
Baby, you trick, you bust. I was making something out of nothing. Chill for real, chill for real. If we can't be lovers and friends, girl, you can show yourself to the door.
Yo, this is J. Cole, what up? With DJ Payne 1.
Yeah, President Tino, keep doing your thing, man. And DJ Aquarius with it, too. Yeah. I'm just happy it's Friday, guys. Hard first week of work. Whew. And I actually gotta see if I got more work. If I got any, let me do that while I'm on here. Chili. Where you at? Good morning, Gas. Gas be great in the building. I'm gonna try to be quiet. I don't know. I'm gonna try to be easy. But I'm about to play this tune, though. Yeah, we're going way back. Back in the time. It's DJ Push Play! I don't even want you to wake up, but I am hyped. So this is what forced me to do these type of songs that I play. I want you to groove with me right now as I see somebody coming up. Maybe it's my co-host. This guy's be great. The Waste Movement is real. You guys should listen to the yesterday show. Very powerful show. As all of them, but I got to save that one. You know what I mean? Yeah. I'll take you back to the cookout. It's I know I got y'all feeling a certain kind of way. Yeah. As they say, man. Good morning, guys.
Good morning. Yes, my baby is growing up. Yes, she is. Oh, God. I'm not ready.
I know you're not. It's good, though.
I'm really not. So, this morning, she got up about 5-10 minutes ago. So I made him go to bed. And you can hear her. I made him go to bed early last night. And she got up this morning when I got up to go do something. Not what it was. She got up. She's like, "Mommy, I gotta go to the bathroom." And I'm like, "Okay, go. You're getting up and you're going to the bathroom? Okay, all right." Because you know we still have her in pull-ups at night. Because she's not gonna pee on every damn thing. No.
Right.
So. Sorry, was like, "Mommy, she didn't even pee in the pull-up."
It was a good fact.
She's learning. I'm tired of buying fucking pull-ups. Good morning, we're done. I am tired of fucking pull-ups, okay?
I'm over it. Yeah, I think she's tired of wearing them.
Over it. Yeah, I think she's tired of wearing them. Yeah, I'm over it. So, yes. My baby will be not two. Sheesh. She will be three next week.
Shit. You got through the terrible two. And you stood up. I heard you. You did. Yeah. You stood up for your rights, mama. And it's going to be okay from now. You're going to get a little help.
It better,
be. You got to just stay on the ground.
It
better be. You already stood up.
Because I get tired of kicking my ass. In real life, get tired. Okay, it's a lot. It's a lot. Clean up behind a 2-year-old all day that wants to that like gets a thrill out of fucking shit up. Like, you know, I wake up wanting to fuck up shit. You know, I don't care if you got to clean it 10 times. I don't care if you have to wipe this down 23 times. It's actually amusing to me to watch you sit here and keep cleaning this shit, and you know I'm gonna fuck it up. Yeah, I made it. I did.
See, you made it, yeah. I'm not gonna say it gets any better.
You don't remind me.
You gotta
don't remind
stay
me.
On.
Just don't remind me. Don't remind me.
Please right now don't I got remind a problem me. With my daughter. It's like she just used too much stuff when she does stuff, so she's allowed to cook. She knows how to cook, but then she'll use all the Italian seasoning. You know what I'm saying? What are you doing? Don't use it all up on one.
Use it in moderation, cost, baby. You know use it in moderation.
And she be going hard. She go in 100%. She always been that way. So she always going
daddy,
hard.
Daddy, I wouldn't be mean if I didn't do it.
0 to 200 right now.
At 12.
No, always. She always been that way, though. When she was little, she was always... When she want to do something, she just go. And then she just do it full. Even if she fuck herself up, she don't care.
Sounds like Somalia. Huh. Interesting. Sounds just like Somalia.
She's my... You know, she's our number one helper here. You know what I'm saying? But we always got to slow her down.
She be always trying to set it off. So, are y'all ready for this week's episode of the Coast to Coast Come Up?
Yeah. We're going to be in your...
In Raleigh. And y'all know I try to make it an adventure. You're not trying to make it a little fun, you know.
Y'all should just go ahead and give guys requests right now. And then just be here. Give it a request and be here.
And make sure you tip. And make sure you tip. Okay, make sure you tip.
If we start doing it that way, it really would be live. If we could get the request ahead of time, right? And then make that into a playlist, right? And then, as long as you show up, you got your request. And if you don't show up, then we got to let other people come in get the slot, right? But, I don't know. We got to consider it. Indie artist, lover, music lovers. The Coast to Coast Come Up is for you. Come in with your indie requests.
Ken said he taking that shit home this week. He said he taking it back to Germany. He said, I'm sick of you Americans. I'm taking it back to Germany. Sorry. Me and Bugatti gonna take this back home. Thanks. I'm taking it this week. Well, I had somewhat of a show last night. This morning.
Did you get everything out that you need to get out, or are you just like,
no, actually, I didn't have a show about that. I didn't have a show about that. Last night it was just my regular 69 Ways to Climax show.
Ooh.
No, give her some time to spend it with you. It was, I was asleep through the whole thing, but you know, because I only play music. That's the only thing. I only play music. That's it. But right. I did. Cisco came through last night.
I'm trying to get Wasted and T to do that.
Like, Nixter, she was like, well, I guess I'm going to sleep in here. She said, good night.
That's what I would do.
Lit. Like, my selection is not, it does not change until about, like, I've literally built a whole playlist where I don't have to touch it. It just plays the slow jams all night long. Stuff you're not even thinking about. Stuff you be done forgot about. Stuff you be like, damn, this shit taking me back. Like, yeah. So, yeah. 69 Ways to Climax is back. I'm trying
to. So, you're going
to
keep it up. It.
I'm gonna try to make it consistent.
I mean,
at least 3 times a week. And I only say that because now, you know, Explosive comes on some of the time. He comes on at 12 midnight. But that's because, you know, of the coast that he's on. So it's 9 o'clock where he's at, but it'll be 12 o'clock over here. So we all try to, like, take turns in, you know, making sure everybody does a show. So, you know, and everybody supports each other. So, yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah, even though I'm still kind of in a sucky-ass mood about next week, you know, but whatever, I guess. It is what it is.
Okay, so what's going on next week? Nothing. Everything.
We don't know.
All
yet.
Of it. Half
everything
of it.
Everything is still like up in the air right now. Like I still don't know.
Uncertainty is the worst.
The uncertainty is the worst, and I still have not spoke to that man.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know what to say about that. I'm like, what?
Yeah, I still have not spoke to that man, and I'm just like, wow. But yet and still, you're waiting until you think I go to sleep to watch my stories. Same thing I said. But in other good news, if you are interested in, if you need like home decor, like living room furniture, bedroom furniture, if you're looking to get like chargers and things like that for your phone, like the wireless chargers where you can just sit your phone on it. Trying to think, what else is it that's up there? Let's see. If you're looking for jewelry, sunglasses, speakers, if you're looking for a case for your iPods, your AirPods, whatever the hell that shit's called. Some of everything, beauty and personal care. You're looking for bundles, some electronics, some apparel, some furniture. Let me know. I just turned my game all the way up. So yeah. Let me know. I actually have living room suits available right now for about $650. I can bring it down maybe to $625, and that does include shipping. That's for U.S. only right now. Now, for overseas, it's a little bit more depending on where you are because, you know, I pay for shipping. You know, that's why I include shipping, you know, make it a little easier. So, yeah. If you're looking for a living room set, let me know. I have a few available. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm turning the game all the way up. Like,
is that DJ Aquarius here? Okay.
All gas, no brakes.
DJ Aquarius.
That's what's up.
Good morning, DJ Aquarius. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. How are y'all?
I'm pretty. I don't feel great. Sound like I'm good. I'm good. I'm good. That sounds more like I'm all right. I'm good, but I'm really not doing good. But I'm really in my feelings right now. But I'm really not trying to vocalize and express it because I'm, you know, trying to figure out, you know, how the rest of the day gonna go. But I'm really feeling some type of way. But I'm not gonna pry.
You know, you completely read me wrong there.
I did. Okay, good. I was really hoping that I was wrong.
Y'all hear my little summer breeze in the background. Yeah.
Okay, maybe he just needed to clear his throat. That's what it was. He just needed to clear his throat.
It's under the water, guys. You know.
Yeah, that's why I said he just had to clear his throat. He just had to clear his throat.
Yeah.
But what's been going on with you, man?
We straight.
Okay. Hey, your daddy a hater because you look better than him. Hey. Okay. All right. Him on dad. This is the first time I got to hear the baby. Oh. Ain't nothing like that smell.
Congratulations,
smell
brother.
So good. Oh my God.
Enjoy.
You better.
Every moment.
Because the next thing you know, she's going to be a Samaya.
Yeah, and then it continues. Yeah.
The marathon continues for real then.
Yeah.
Because it's to the point now, I don't even make Samaya take a nap anymore during the day. Unless I'm just like seriously over her for the day. And I'm just like, okay, that's it. What time is it? It's 2 o'clock? Oh, yeah, you can take a quick little 2-3 hour nap. You'll go back to sleep at like 9:30. It's okay. Sorry. Yep. There
man,
it is.
2 days ago. You say what? I said I got her 2 days ago. And
well, that's good.
And is this going to be a continuous thing or the agreement or what's going on? Are you full time daddy? For a minute. While her mom takes care of some stuff. Makes sense.
Well, that's a good thing.
Well, you know, blessings upon that. For real, man. I hope everything, you know, I'm praying for you. Everything's good.
Yeah. I mean, we're going to be all right. I just got to, get a little balance so I can still do everything because I wasn't really doing everything like I was supposed to in the first place. But, I can't keep this job thing going. I got to get back to my entrepreneurial spirit.
Yeah,
say the least. So
I ain't quite there yet, but they trying to force me there. I tell you, but I'm not quite there. We'll see.
It's a lot.
I feel like it will force me out. The job will force me out. My job. It's going to force me out. Because I almost got in some trouble over the summer. No, I'm just saying that a parent actually came up with the student and parent came up to the school during COVID time because, they thought it was, well, they blamed me because of me, because to them, it was my fault. You know what I'm saying? But, and my boss from another department called me. Because it went through the school that I suck. Right?
That you suck at what? All
right, so I'm a virtual advisor, but I'm a faculty virtual advisor, so I'm supposed to have a set list of students that I deal with in my department that I work as a faculty. But because it's virtual and it's new and all of this, and because we've had the switch where everybody's had the switch, they tamper with the system where I start getting regular students just coming in, right? So I'm handling those students. I'm handling the students. Boom, boom, boom. But they noticed what they did, and I guess they didn't want nobody to find out. So then they take all my privileges away and make me just a tutor, okay? So then tutors in the system can't do shit. So, but listen to this. But all of those students all of those students that see that I'm ready to take appointments, they still see that I'm ready to take appointments, DJ Aquarius and Gas. Right. They still see, they think I'm available, right? And I'm like, so I'm hitting them up like, dog, you... And they hit me up first and said, look, it looks like you're taking our students, you're not supposed to have them. We're going to just make you a tutor. Boom. And assistant. That's what they did. That's, they just told me, point blank, that's what they do. I hit them back. I was like, what about all these students? You know what I'm saying? Then they explain. Oh, yeah, you only supposed to handle your faculty, your department students. You're not supposed to handle all our students. Because this is advising and retention department. Oh, you ain't supposed to handle all our students. So we cut it off. All those students are going to go to the call center. I was like, what the fuck? Right? I'm going off on them. So it's all in the emails. I'm going off on them. But they're like, so what? It's going to go to the call center. Everything's going to be all right. Go talk to your department and let them know what's going on with your status in the system. So they wouldn't fix my status. They wouldn't put me. All right. Okay. So I see students start hitting me up. What's up? Where the link at? Where the Zoom at? Look, what are we going to do? And I'm like, I can't do nothing. So I hit them all back and said, look, technical difficulties. I can't hit you up. You know what I'm saying? Please reschedule. You understand? But they was like, if you're going to cancel, why don't you cancel in the damn system? And I'm like, no. Oh, well, you know, technical difficulties. I can't do nothing. I can't cancel. I can't. So I'm sorry you see this inconvenience. Then I get messages of people, their parents took off work for the meeting and all this and that. And I hit them back. Sorry for inconvenience. Customer service, right? But I already know. They kept on going to the call center. And so what ended up happening afterwards was they went up there and complained. And they complained about me, my name, everything, because that's who they saw. You know what I'm saying? And they said, I mean, I'm still at that status, right? So they switched me back to faculty, to my right status, after talking with all my other bosses, because all of them are embarrassed because their employee is the asshole who leaving the students out to dry. Anywho, we'll see how it go. I love it. I still love my job.
Complained on you for the system restriction.
Yeah, so basically...
Well, that's good.
I mean, I feel like it's good if things get sorted out. And I know I got record to defend, you know, my stance. But people look for scapegoats, you know what I'm saying? They want to look good. We all put under this where this system, it took me a year and a half to learn it. But now the whole school has to use it. And... the people above, I just frankly, they don't know how to use it. And so they're fucking it up. And then they don't want to look bad. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Somebody got to get blamed, right? If it come down to it.
Yeah. And that's probably going to be you because you have the intelligence level to handle that.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good with handling that. As long as they good with, if they good, so you know, these are these politics now. You feel with the politics, you're going to take care of me even though I was the scapegoat. Because I don't mind looking bad. The system is, we're trying to learn. You know what I'm saying? Yeah,
let's just be honest. The whole entire,
yeah,
the whole entire 2020 has been ghetto as hell. Let's just be honest. It's been ghetto.
Well, no, I don't want to be a scapegoat, but I'd be a martyr.
I feel like a model right now, but and I have some allies, but it's just like, who knows? Who knows how, are they going to be like the NBA players and say, fuck the paycheck, I'm going home, you know what I'm saying? Right now, for my man, who's, you know, sticking up for the students, or they gonna, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Or they're going to be like, you know, anyway. We'll see. Because I know how the school, how it works. And people have to get blamed. It's not just me. I'm just one instance. I guarantee. But people got to get blamed. And there probably is negligent virtual advisors who work in the advising department, right? Because they're not used to doing it. You see what I'm saying? So it's easy to blame me. But I told them, man, until they took my privileges away, every single student that I could handle, I handled. And I was still handling students via email, but I didn't have the powers to look in their record or do the stuff that I was supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? They were asked. So, anyway.
I mean, you did a good thing, and you're still doing a good thing, and you always going to do great things, bro.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Keep it going. I'm rooting for my wife right now. She just went all but dissertation. And if you don't know what that means, is her prospectus, which is basically her plan for research, was accepted for her PhD. And now she's got about 6 months to a year of, you know, getting data. And then she just really present that data and defend that data as what happened. And she get her PhD. She's a doctor. You know what I'm saying? Dr. Joy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she can get a job before that. We could end up in Canada because there's Canada looking at her right now.
Thank me.
But she works at Howard now, so I don't know. And she always wanted to work at an HBCU. This is why she started that. This I remember before she had.
Y'all got kids, right?
Huh? Yeah, y'all we got two kids, right?
Little ones, yeah. Go to Canada.
12 and 10. Mm-hmm.
12 yeah. And 10.
Go to Canada, bro.
Nah, I'm not. I'm open to all of it, but we're not going to sell our house. We're going to just... We might rent it out. Yeah.
Would you include the utilities if you would have rented out?
You say what?
Would you include the utilities? Because, you know, you could put some of the...
We can work it out. It's all just numbers. It's easy to work out numbers.
Yeah, because you know you can put those lock boxes on your thermostat. I've seen it happen.
It's easy to work out numbers. And there's a lot of stuff we got to sort out here at this house. It's an old house. So, but it's ours. It's in the family. We're keeping it in the family. The in-laws, they got a new house. They built that house in Jacksonville. We want to keep that house too. So, if we get something in Canada, we want to keep that. But we might not get something. We might just rent or do, you know, live in Canada and work. You know, here. Get money. They pay. It's some guap. You know what I'm saying? So, anyway.
Well. You gotta do what's best for you. That's the only. That's what I'm gonna always say. Do what's best for you.
You say fast forward. We fast forward. Yeah.
Can we fast forward to 2021? Can you bring me my phone back, please? Thank you.
I have so much to do now, and I appreciate having so much to do now. And I think this is a year before that everything is really gonna pop off. I'm glad that you guys got your Bitcoin. Hold that thing. Like I said. If you didn't remember, I am the night. You know what I'm saying? I'm the abundant night this year. So things I pass out, things I do, usually it's just going to grow. You know what I'm saying? It might look like it's going down. Or look like, even when it grows just a little bit, don't get antsy because I believe it's going to grow a whole lot more than you think. You know what I'm saying? So
I'm going to just let it sit there. And just let it sit. 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 Cause now, like I said, I've been turned the game all the way up now. Cause now, like, I have a laser tattoo removal machine. I have that for about $5,500, and that's including shipping.
I see what you're doing. Now, see, these type of products, I need to introduce you. You open, I'm going to introduce you personally to my partner, YFM Media, right? And you guys can cut a deal. And he's an expert. He's an expert seller at specific items. But I'm saying he'll get off your items. Y'all can work it out. And he'll get your items off. He'll sell that shit. Mm-hmm. He always sells. All his items, he always sells. Especially electronic shit like that. Hell yeah. That's what he does.
Yeah, I don't have a whole lot of electronics. Because I didn't want to dabble in that too much.
That's what I said.
But you know, I have stuff like permanent hair removal kits. Like I said, I have jewelry. I have them for five from anywhere from like it just depends on which one you get.
Okay.
I mean, they range all the way up from like the basic one for like $20 all the way up to like.
So you get into you basically got all kinds of products.
Merchandise.
Useful.
Yeah.
That's what's up. You've been seeing those videos I've been putting in the DM, right? Because I know you've been dibbling. We dibbled and got our, we can get our followers and stuff like that and experiment, but just translate that into sales. That's what I'm saying.
I even have candles. What? What y'all need?
I sold one shirt.
You said what shirt?
Yeah, one shirt.
You know what? He sounded so accomplished when he said that, though. And I...
It's good. Yeah. Honestly, if you can sell one, you can sell 100. You know what I'm saying? You just got to scale up for who was interested in the shirt and then hone in and target those folks, right? Spend a little money. If you are spending money already, you just need to change your analytics a little bit. You can spend a little bit, get a little bit more out of it. So what you got to look at, if you are spending money, DJ Aquarius, is how many people engaged in it in the post that got you the sale versus the sale itself. You know what I'm saying? And you want to look at the extent of that. And if it's a good percentage, and what you're really looking for is about 1-3%. So then you just need to add more money.
Mm-hmm. So I'll say this. I have not spent any money. The commercials that we made, I made them all in-house. I only use my social media, and then he has a Pinterest, right?
And yeah.
He spends money, right? For his Pinterest. But no shirts have been bought through people coming in off Pinterest.
Okay. You got it from your own influence, organic influence. Right. Yeah. So that's what I was trying to see.
That's what I was trying to see, like within the first month or two, what organic influence was going to do before I started spending money.
What you're supposed to do.
Yeah, that way I would know.
It's a very precious sale.
Whether it was more important to pay for more influence. Because if my organic influence was going to do enough, right? If the people I know were going to be supportive in general, then I was going to pay for more commercials, etc. If not, then I'm going to pay for, you know, the Google ads and promo and all of that type of stuff. Right? So I was trying to see which one.
What my teacher taught me was you go directly at what worked and build on it, and I agree with that so much because I believe in that before he taught me that about this. And so what you got to do is take all the analytics that go along with the sale, right, and then market. He would take the same post, and then he would put like $5 on those analytics in the same platform where the sale was made.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. And then what I'm saying, he would market that post to get more sales using the analytics from the sale.
Okay.
And that's what I would do too. Because I'm a good student.
I don't learn so much. I feel like I just get so much information.
The way that you know if you're successful with it is by the engagement you get versus how many sales you get. And like I said, you're really only looking for 1 to 3% to be successful. If you get over that, your shit is damn viral. And if you put it, if you spend it five and if you put 100 on it, you can, you know, make, you know, tons and tons of money right there within the next, you know. Because the way it works, it's right now. It's really, the money is unlimited right now. It's not like over time. Over time is finding that ratio, those numbers that I'm talking about. And that's it. I know I'm making it oversimplified. And I see what they've been doing as far as the GUI of it or the displays. They've been making them actually more difficult to me. You know, more complicated, more options.
I was about to say, you're supposed to simplify. That's what they taught us in math.
But the thing about it, it's all about the numbers. And that's how I was trained about it. And when you follow it and you can see the science with the numbers, then you know that when you spend your dollars, you see what I'm saying, on your advertising, that you get your yield, you get your return in your investment. You're investing in yourself, right?
Yeah, you get your return.
Now, and it's wonderful
now
life.
I see why they don't like you as a teacher, man.
Why? Because I go straight to the point, right?
Yeah. You're doing
and
too
so,
much.
Yeah. This is, I get in trouble for teaching, too. I have before, but I've adjusted myself, but not in the way that I give out the information. But just how I give out the work.
It's just funny because, you know, the rule of math, the first rule of math is simplify. So when we're talking about numbers, how are you going to make it complicated?
You shouldn't, man. People do. And it's hard. It's hard out here, man. It's rough, right? Because you see, this I told you, this is the secret of everything, right? All right, so I told you that. But this is why online marketing is considered like hacking. Because for the regular people. So, I mean, and this is what I'm saying. Even all that stuff about the Trump election, which is not false, that Russia or whoever paid for marketing, but they just did the same kind of formula as I did to get it done. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's not illegal to do. Maybe the content that they're pushing is illegal now, but it wasn't then. So these are modes of where you can have, you know, really for a social change, or you can just get off all your products. You know what I'm saying? You can get off all your stuff and live and actually stay. You don't have to be out there, you know, really. You know what I'm saying? Nobody knows those numbers but you.
Okay, so I have to ask you a question, too.
Mm-hmm.
Off subject, I apologize, but you put something up, right, about the seven chakras.
Oh, yeah.
And the elements the other day, right? And you know my brand is the whole Live Your Element brand. I try not to overwhelm people with information, so that's why we started with astrology, right?
Yeah.
Because people are more familiar with astrology and how
right.
It transitions into living your element, right? But I definitely was looking into some designs about the chakras. I like those designs you did, right? So I don't know if you saw my comment, but when you put it up, I said, bro, that's my next phase in the whole Live Your Element brand, right?
That's what's up.
Who designed those? Whose designs are those?
Okay, those are my wife's. My wife did those. She painted those. Yeah, she can paint it for you. But you can send her like a sketch or something. She would paint that thing for you. I don't know. Like,
yeah, she likes to get paintbrush.
That's what she do. That's something that's coming out that she has to get out right now. That's coming out of her. And, you know, I support that. And I actually put those up as Redbubble designs so that people can get them on different items and stuff. Like
I got to go through mine too and revamp some stuff. So
I don't know how much she charge. She usually don't charge anything, but I don't. But we'll see. She use it for her. Right now, we're working with the school to do like the kids' school to do for parents though, like paint or family. paint sessions virtually. We'll be painting different designs. You know, just because. So it's all good. So you need something drawn or made up? Because
No, I really was just admiring how perfectly they fit into the whole scheme of things. So I was really curious what it
would take. You can feel free to use them. You want to use them? I don't see why not. They out there.
I don't see my wife getting mad.
Now, if you want to be, and that's what I be telling people about that stuff about using things. Always, and you didn't even have to talk to them. Always, just give credit. That's it. And for us, for me, DJ Quest, to give credit, that'll be like sending it back. We're just saying, you know, where it came from.
Yeah.
That's it. Hmm. And you can use it for whatever. That's how they're doing academia, by the way. Academia.
Yeah, I mean, you got to give credit where the credit is due. That's the whole rule of information right now. You can put something up there for free, but I mean for sale, but you have to also, if you put something new on the internet, the rule of the internet is anything you put up for sale, you have to also put somewhere where they can access it for free.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. When you take the free stuff. If you're giving credit, you're doing a great job. If you're not,
what do you mean by access it for free?
Like, there is nothing on the internet that is for sale as far as knowledge-wise. Products are different, but knowledge-wise, that is only for sale. If you find it for sale anywhere and it's information, you should be able to continue searching and find that exact same information all under how to follow the process, how to develop something yourself, how to create something yourself. From the internet itself to a web page to an email server, right? You should find any of that type of information. It should be completely and totally free because it's all about spreading the knowledge. That was the whole point in designing the internet.
So, yeah, that's it. So, this is an example, guys. This is an example. My students have to go, in one of my classes, I teach interpersonal communication. My students have to use this system called MindTap. Right, to do their work, you know what I'm saying? And they need an access code, right? So, and I give them the book and everything, but what I'm doing right now diligently is looking for the free access code, right? Because I know for a fact, and this is a lot of students already got it, you know what I'm saying? Because students want to pass, they want to do their thing, but some students may not be able to get it, dog. You understand what I'm saying? So then what I'm going to do for them? You know what I'm saying? How can I? And I'm looking for that because I know exactly what DJ Aquarius said. It exists. Same thing with ebooks. If it's an ebook, don't you believe me, it's a free copy.
Yeah, it's somewhere.
Right.
It's somewhere. That's the rule.
It makes sense to me. It makes a lot of sense. That's why I said, that's why I was asking you to explain. Have y'all seen what y'all president been doing?
I think
see the popular meme with his wife? You haven't seen it?
You want me to tell you the flaw of Trump? Because he would be winning right now if he would just acknowledge black folks fully and the plight that we're going through with inequality.
No, you know he wouldn't. He can't win.
I don't think he can win either because I believe that he thinks if he does that, he's going to lose. You know what I'm saying? If he even mentioned it. So they skate around it and say these things.
Well, the problem with Trump is he not no politician, man. He don't know how to play that game. Like, people talk about that.
Jingle said yesterday
that.
He's doing it like that, and he whack with it because you can't do that as the president. Well, you're going to get fired. That's what I'm saying. He better get fired with the election, and he might try to stay in. I don't know what y'all trying to say he's going to do, but. And he's trying to run the other narrative, but, dog, you got to look. Don't say, I'm trying to keep all of the sports in. And not mention that there's a boycott.
Yeah,
he won't even mention it. Like, he won't even mention it. He won't even say, sad, boycott, or he won't even mention, he won't, I didn't hear it. I was like, is he going to say anything about that? He going to talk about sports?
He don't talk negatively about it if he do, because the people that
I think so too.
The people that are voting for him support it in a negative aspect. He's getting voted in by the races. That is the content he took up. We have to remember
the majority, even the majority of races ain't really racist. They like, whoa, wait a minute. I'm just saying he fucking up.
There's
too
know
many
how
white people outside, man. It's not.
I don't know.
I'm not. Black folks. Most black folks is inside.
Like,
our young
you
folks are
it,
outside, but most black folks is inside.
When you look
who's
at
outside
it right now, right? We came up more under President Trump, like financially, economically, and it's more out of necessity, right? Because we see the world ain't gonna do nothing for us, right? So we starting to do some shit for ourselves, right? Everybody, even the lower class people are starting to do shit for ourselves. We came up a lot with Trump, right? When we've been having presidents give us lip service like they were for us, where every time we walk
did
away,
did you say lip service? Oh wow,
yeah.
Nice choice of words.
I agree. I mean, we talked about it yesterday. That's why we were talking about Ice Cube negotiating the deal for. Because, and that some people are like, that's drastic, you know what I'm saying? But nah, it's like, what's going on out here? Because Ice Cube, we talking way off the cuff now, but I bet you he can cut that deal. You
he
know
ain't
what I'm
in NWA no more.
That's his skill.
I mean,
that's
he
his
is
skill. Even in NWA, if they would have let him cut the deals and listen to him about the deals, you know, the whole ruthless would be a whole different thing. You know what I'm saying? It's, come on, let's just be honest.
Your legs like, not turning over.
Because he wasn't doing good business.
So, my only question is, if people don't realize we actually doing better now, right, whether we don't like the situation or not, the pressure is on, right, which is why we rising. You know, that's what happens. You add a little heat, you add pressure, you know, things start to rise, diamonds start
bubbling up.
Yeah, gold gets purified. And so, but we don't like it. It makes us uncomfortable. And so people care not to acknowledge it, but we are doing better. But how do you get people to acknowledge that and indeed vote for him while he drops the bullshit narrative so that we can stop with the phony arguments? You know, we don't know how to do that. Don't nobody know how to do that.
So you say we should vote for him. How you doing, Shinadi?
Good morning. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. You think we should vote for him? DJ Aquarius, that's what you're saying.
I feel like Biden ain't nothing but another trick. We put Biden in office. This man just said, you ain't black if you ain't vote for him. But he don't got no black policies. He don't got nothing in favor of us. And the last time we voted for somebody just because we was black, the gay people ended up with more rights than us.
Right? DJ supposed to say, whoa.
You know what I mean?
You start in trouble. Look, you
I'm
just,
like, what did I walk into?
You get into the DJ Cisco category.
I'm not about Trump. I'm just not about no more tricks, y'all. I'm tired. Every time we get a band-aid from the Democrats, we get hurt later, dog.
So I just look like, you know, Trump's tricks hurt immediately. And I know what you're saying about the other side. Their tricks hurt down the line.
Yeah, we never know what's going to happen.
So I don't know which one you like.